We took about a year to design the cardiovascular floor. It was an intense process that involved a number of providers, staff, folks from facilities, because what we were trying to design was a space in which we could provide uplifting, healing cardiovascular care. And so as we were designing it, it became very important for us to be able to study what we were doing, to develop metrics and ways in which we could continue to improve the care delivery process.
So we had this brand new building, and when we were moving units over, we were hearing a lot of feedback from the nursing staff on the changes in their workflow and how that impacted their daily work and to be able to deliver care to our patients. At the same time, Lindsey and Allison and a few others had just completed their research in the emergency department and did a post-occupancy evaluation. In talking with Lindsey and collaborating with them, we were able to really expand the data that we collected and the goals that we had.
It's been a truly collaborative project with interdisciplinary partners from the UK College of Design, College of Communication and Information, UK HealthCare, Pharmacy, and then of course having our students involved. In the fall of 2014, we initiated the research process and we went into the old hospital and examined how they were working in this space. About 6 months after the move to the new environment, we then went back in to examine again through these same methods how the design was contributing to patient safety, to caregiver satisfaction.
The perspective that we came from was to find out more about the daily workflow, to follow nurses through every footstep they took, to be able to see where were they walking the most, where were they spending the most time, and how could we ensure that they had the time at the bedside with their patients, which is where we know nurses are most happy.
The move to the eighth floor marked an important change for UK HealthCare in that they moved from a centralized unit design to a decentralized unit design.
In the new floor, the nurses are actually located immediately outside the patient's rooms. The decentralized model really puts the nursing care right at the bedside, where the patients and the family are, where they need nursing level care.
And so the pedometer data was very valuable because it allowed us to compare the old unit with the current unit. The nurses said that they were walking much more. Well, what did that actually look like? We also did survey data, and that was to collect broad range data about the old environment versus the new. We did observation, which was a big part of the students' involvement. So having a third party watch where they're going, it was really nice to have the data from the students to see where they're walking, where these communication circles were, because we wanted to see in a space that was much larger, where are those conversations taking place that are so critical?
My favorite part of the project was really getting to understand how a healthcare environment works and seeing how the nurses, physicians, and staff work in the cardiovascular unit. I was a part of the behavioral mapping observations. I entered a lot of the data, the observational mapping and then surveys into the computer, and then after that it was sent to the statistician where he analyzed it, and I took that data and then I created graphics to show it in a more simplistic way so it was easier for the reader to see. Being involved in research like this I think is really important because a lot of the design firms are doing pre and post occupancy evaluations with their design projects, and so it teaches you how to do those things, and then also it gives you kind of more experience on the research side and understanding why it is important to do research when you are designing a space, because as designers, we're designing for the people, so it's important for us to understand how they work and operate in the environment that we're designing.
We had a lot of positive responses to the new environment. Overwhelmingly, people were enthusiastic about the great views from the eighth floor.
That daylight infusing in on patients was good for patients to be able to see what was going on in the outside world. There was good ability to move the patients around that environment. If the patient was in a wheelchair or had crutches, the threshold to the bathroom was large enough to be able to navigate that. This was a cardiology unit, so they had the ability to pull up certain EKG monitoring on their computers that they were sitting at just in real time. And to be right there with their patients, right outside of the room, also made them feel very good.
One of the things that we did with our outcomes was make short and long-term suggestions for improvement.
Some of the shorter-term goals, could we put in monitors where they had identified monitors were needed? We needed to come up with some type of lighting right at their desk outside of the patient's room that would allow them to be able to see their paperwork, but still being right there with the patients. Sort of longer term things that we looked at, do we have enough unlicensed staff, so our nursing care techs in the environment, to be able to go and get the supplies and the equipment to keep the nurse at the bedside with the patient, stratifying what is the easy win that we can get out there now, like the lighting at the computers, and then what will take just a little bit more time and thinking about that.
To be able to collect data on metrics in terms of how effective this care delivery model is, how active the nurses are on the floor, how this has impacted care, really will be of critical value as we roll out new floors and as we try to tweak what we're doing on a day-to-day basis.